You can create these colorful bangles in friendly plastic in just minutes with a few strips of friendly plastic and a bangle bracelet from the Dollar Jewelry Store. Stay tuned, I'll show you how. This is one of those projects that is going to incorporate a lot of those leftover pieces of friendly plastic that you have from other projects. And if you don't have leftover pieces, it's okay. You can cut apart your pieces of friendly plastic to any shape that you want. I'm also using the water method. This doesn't really have a temperature setting on it, but I have it so that it's not too hot to put my fingers in and it's not boiling. It's the most important part. You'll need some jewelry glue. I also have a few cabochons sitting right here. And I am using a metal cuff that I purchased at one of the inexpensive dollar jewelry stores. I'll be working on a nonstick mat, and this is probably the most important tool that you're going to use today, which is a needle tool. And it's just a pointed tool, a little metal pointed tool. So I'm going to work directly on my cuff, and I'm using this as a form. So I want you to know that your plastic initially is not going to stick to this. What you're using this for is just to create the shape so that you can go back in when you're finished making your pattern and glue the plastic down, and then it will conform to the shape of your cuff. Now generally I start with a lighter color plastic, and I'm using my leftover pieces. Using the water method makes it really easy to stretch and pinch and poke and curl and twist. And you're just going to bunch that up and lay that right down onto the plastic, and you can see it is not flat. So don't be concerned about getting it flat unless you specifically want it flat. And then you're going to come back in with all your different pieces of color and lay them on one over another, layering, layering, layering. That's kind of the key to this project here. This is fun. So when you get ready to set a stone here, I've got a little glass marble that I like. I'm just going to push that down, and then I'm going to set a piece right over the top. That just kind of encases it and holds it in there. You will probably have to put a little dab of glue just to make sure that that stays in there permanently. But then I also have some strips hanging out here. These are fun because you can twist and curl these around. And add pattern. There's no right or wrong here. This is simply a matter of your taste and your color palette. You can make this to fit an outfit that you already have in your wardrobe, or you know what's even more fun is just create. Don't worry about the colors that you have in your wardrobe. Go shopping for something that matches it after work. That's a reason to go shopping. So I'm just going to keep doing what I'm doing, laying layer upon layer, color upon color, and when I'm finished, it will look something like this one. This one's my finished one here. And I just want to show you that I have glued all of the pieces down with my jewelry glue. Just take in and make sure that your plastic is completely cool before you start touching it. It usually takes about, 2 to 3 minutes. And then add your glue. Lay it down, allow your glue to dry. My glue is a real quick drying glue. And then I came in and I added all of these little different rhinestones. And this one I put in there when I was making it. And you'll want to, if you do add any glass marbles or anything like that, you want to make sure those are glued down. So you can come in and arrange all of your pretty dainties. It's not limited to crystals. You could use pearls, beads, anything that you have. This is your bracelet. Make it your own. For more friendly plastic ideas and inspiration, visit us on our blog at friendlyplastic.blogspot.com.